James A. Allison opened his Indianapolis manufacturing plant in 1915, his goal was to improve technology in race cars. His immediate objective was to prepare a racing car that could outrun foreign entries in the race that became the Indianapolis 500. Not only did he succeed, but his engineering acumen helped advance American race car technology into a new era. During World War I, Allison again responded to industry needs and turned to overhauling Liberty aircraft engines. In 1934, his engineering company became the Allison Division of General Motors, established to design and build high-performance power plants. From its inception, Allison's company was an engineer's engineering firm. He was interested in any engineering problem that created a challenge for his small but competent staff. Allison's expertise in internal combustion engines, automotive, marine, and aircraft was their principal asset when General Motors purchased the company in 1929. Allison's work for the Navy on diesel engines was another important area of experience. The decade following was primarily one of development work on various projects, such as the 750-horsepower dirigible engine for the Navy. Allison also attempted to interest the Army in a liquid-cooled aircraft engine. Allison was convinced that future expansion of range and speed in fighter aircraft would be made with liquid-cooled rather than air-cooled engines. The largest air-cooled engine at that time was 750 horsepower. But the Army wasn't interested in listening. After all, no one else was working on liquid-cooled technology. Allison persisted, however, and in 1937, the now-famous V-1710 successfully completed tests at Wright Field. The United States had its first 1,000-horsepower engine, and everybody wanted it. The U.S. Army, Great Britain, and France. The next year, an Allison V-1710-powered P-40 won the U.S. Air Force 1938 fighter aircraft competition with a speed advantage of 40 miles per hour. Mass production of V-1710 engines got underway in early 1940, and when Pearl Harbor was attacked, production had climbed to 1,000 engines per month. 3,500 of the engines had been delivered worldwide. With this tremendous growth, Allison needed more room. Existing buildings were enlarged, and in 1942, ground was broken for a new 2-million-square-foot production plant. This unit became plant number 5 when it went into production only 4 months later. Large numbers of civilians and military personnel had to be taught engine servicing, so Allison established a training center. Midway in the war, the need for an engine installation and flight test facility dictated the construction of another Allison building at Weir Cook Municipal Airport. Production peaked in 1943 at approximately 3,000 engines per month, when employment reached its all-time high of over 23,000. By the end of the war, Allison had built 70,000 liquid-cooled engines for Lockheed P-38 Lightnings, North American P-51 Mustangs, and a host of other aircraft worldwide. Near the final stages of the global conflict, the Air Force asked Allison to accept another major challenge, the development of a new type of engine. Some German airplanes with turbine engines had gone into combat, and plans were rushed to get similar jets into combat for our Air Force. Allison responded to the challenge and delivered its first J-33 jet engine in early 1945. Allison-powered aircraft began to establish new records. In 1947, a shooting star brought the world speed record back to the United States for the first time in 20 years, with a speed in excess of 600 miles an hour. Allison responded to our country's call again during the Korean War. As war clouds hung over South Korea, the U.S. threw Allison-powered F-80s and F-82 twin Mustangs to repulse communist invaders. The J-33-powered F-80 destroyed a MiG-15 to become the first jet fighter to knock down an enemy jet in aerial combat. The J-33 became the first jet engine to operate 1,000 hours before overhaul, a landmark in technological achievement. The following year, Allison delivered the first T-40 turboprop engine, and 3 years later, the T-56 was introduced. The Civil Aeronautics Commission's first approval of a turboprop engine for commercial operation was received by Allison's Model 501 in 1955. In 1958, testing got underway on a 250-horsepower gas turbine engine for small military and commercial aircraft. Dry weight of this engine was only 106 pounds. It was light, efficient, and would provide a level of performance unknown to small and medium aircraft. In only 4 years of development, the 250-horsepower T-63 turboshaft engine for light observation helicopters received military approval. Even after half a century, Allison Division continued to mark milestones to progress. In April 1966, the T-63-powered Hughes helicopter broke 23 world records in speed, altitude, and distance. This engine became the predecessor to today's 250 series. 1973 was a historic year for the Model 250 gas turbine. A new 400-horsepower version, the 250C20, was introduced and scheduled for production. The following year, the C20B turboshaft for helicopters and the 250B17B turboprop for fixed-wing aircraft entered production. In 1977, we introduced the 250C30, 650-horsepower model, with the rollout of the Sikorsky twin-engine helicopter. At a continuous rating of 650 shaft horsepower per engine and a weight of only 235 pounds, it has outstanding horsepower to weight ratio with excellent fuel consumption and exhaust gas emission characteristics. 1980 marked more major advances for the 250 gas turbine engine with the completion of what is believed the first transatlantic flight by a light helicopter. The flight proved that a single engine helicopter was capable of outstanding performance on a long journey. The engine which powered the flight was a Model 250 C28B turboshaft engine. In March of the same year, the 250 C30 set a new world speed record for point-to-point travel. Yes, the 250 series engines have proven themselves where it counts, in tough, demanding applications on land, at sea, and in the air. The Model 250 has evolved through five significant generations of impressive improvement. The first 250-horsepower model was upgraded to 317 shaft horsepower and called the 250C18. It powered helicopters by Hughes, Hiller Aircraft, the Bell Jet Ranger, and a twin-engine model by Messerschmitt Bolko Blohm. 1969 brought FAA certification for the 250B15 turboprop engine for light fixed-wing aircraft. The Cessna 402 was the first commercial U.S. aircraft to employ the new engine, while Australia used it for a light twin, and Italy used it for a military observation aircraft. The latest versions of this engine, the 250B17C and the aerobatic 250B17D, are employed in aircraft produced by Cessna, Beechcraft, CI Marchetti, Composite Aircraft, Australia, Thailand, Pilatus Britten Norman, Valmet, and Partenavia. In the 1970s, the Allison 250 Series 2, rated at 420 shaft horsepower, was developed, and today powers aircraft by Hughes, Bell, Augusta, Aerospatiale, Hiller, MBB, and Rhein-Flusikbau. Later, the Series 3 made its impact on the marketplace. Rated at 500 horsepower, the 250 C28 bettered its own performance ratings in power and fuel specifics. It was selected to provide power for the Bell 206L1 and the MBB BO105LS. The Series 4 made its debut in 1976. Rated at 650 horsepower, it was the engine of choice for the Hughes 530, the twin-engine Sikorsky, and two Bell helicopters, the 406 and the 206 Long Ranger.